So I'm driving down the road listening to a talk radio show, and I hear the host say that kimchi, a fermentable food, can regrow hair. That got my attention, and ultimately this proved to be more complicated than I thought. So let's now look at the research on probiotics as a method to regrow hair, and there is research on this, and it includes more than just kimchi. In this study, you're looking at 22 healthy men and women are given a shampoo that contains a specific strain of lactobacillus bacteria called GMNL6, which they used each day for 5 months. It's reported that not only did the people's hair growth improve, but so too did their dandruff. That said, these people were healthy and they weren't balding, so let's move on to the next trial. In this clinical study, we have 26 men and women who are indeed experiencing hair loss. They are given a probiotic supplement twice a day for 3 months. These researchers report that a whopping 96% of the people using the probiotic saw an improvement in not only their hair density, but there was also a reduction in hair loss too. And as proof, they show us graphs like this one. But again, there are no before and after pictures. Next up is this paper where 31 men and women who are dealing with hair loss are given a probiotic that they inhaled, yes, inhaled, each day for 12 weeks. Likewise, these researchers also report that the probiotic resulted in, quote, statistically significant increases in the number of hairs on the scalp after just 4 weeks of use. And that's great to hear, but once again, they don't show us any before and after pictures. Moving on, we have this paper with a provocative title where 56 men and women experiencing hair loss are given a shampoo that contained a plant extract along with lactobacillus bacteria, and we are told that they use this shampoo once a day for 24 weeks. That's almost 6 months. So it's reported that this shampoo resulted in significant improvements in the number of hairs on people's scalps compared to before they were using the shampoo. However, once again, there are no before and after pictures presented in this study, which for a clinical trial that lasted 6 months is an epic fail in my book. And that brings us full circle to this study on kimchi and hair growth, where 46 men and women who are experiencing hair loss are given a combination of kimchi and a fermented soybean food twice a day for 4 months. And to compare results before and after, the researchers measure the hair count on the scalp 1 month later and 4 months later to see if any changes occurred. Now, they tell us in the paper that after just 1 month of taking this probiotic, 63% of the men showed significant improvements in hair count and hair thickness. And as further proof, they show us pie charts like this showing improvements in both men and women who were in this study. But once again, what they don't show in this paper are any before and after pictures. Also, let's remember in this paper, the kimchi was combined with a fermentable soy-based food, which totally contradicts what I heard on the talk radio show. Based on the lack of before and after pictures in any of the studies that I uncovered, I'm not prepared to say that probiotics or kimchi itself regrows hair on the heads of people in any meaningful way that you could see with your own eyes. However, for those who want to try this for yourself, or maybe you're trying probiotics right now to see if it regrows your hair, here is a summary of the types of bacteria that were used in the various studies I outlined in this video, and some also that I didn't mention as well. Feel free to stop the video and take a screenshot of this table so you can compare the types of probiotics that were used in the studies to the supplements and shampoos that you may be using right now.